I'm Chris Teal. I'll speak to you on lattice reduction with LLLplus.jl. You may ask, what is a lattice? A practical definition starts with a fixed basis matrix. Each lattice point corresponds to the product of a basis matrix and some vector of integers. Each lattice point has a different vector of integers that it corresponds to. The set of all possible lattice points constitutes the lattice. The top of the right column, we give a basis matrix for this lattice illustrated in the figure. And the green lattice point shown corresponds to that basis matrix times the vector of integers 0, 1. Here are some a couple of other lattice points shown in red and purple, and the corresponding integer vectors. You may also wonder why you should care about lattices. Well, in general, lattice tools are often used where you might imagine using linear algebra or solving some other system of equations, but you really want an integer-valued solution. So surprisingly, going to an integer-valued requirement makes these problems kind of tough. In fact, some of the problems are so tough that future powerful quantum computers cannot solve them efficiently. So cryptographers are building post-quantum cryptography on top of lattice problems. There are lots of other fun problems which use lattice tools. Unfortunately, we don't have time to talk about them all. There are an infinite number of bases for a lattice. Here, the red arrows illustrate the columns of the BRED matrix, and the green arrows illustrate the columns of the B-green basis matrix. Many problems, we want the short, close to orthogonal basis like the green one. In this process of going from a not so great basis matrix to a better basis is called lattice reduction, which you can think of as a bit like a QR matrix decomposition for integer problems. The most important lattice reduction technique is from Lenstra-Lenstra-Lovacsz. It's known as the LLL algorithm. Here is pseudocode for it. It calls a size reduction subroutine. Here is pseudocode for that subroutine. Unfortunately, we don't have a lot of time to spend on this or on this Julia code for a givens-based LLL. Rather, we'll just tell you a couple things that you should remember about the LLL, and that is that it's fast and it does a pretty good job of reducing the basis. In fact, it's so good at these things that this LLL brought lots of attention to lattice tools about 40 years ago. Okay, we've spent a bit of time on some basics. We've talked about lattice reduction. Now let's talk briefly about the package, LLLplus.jl. It contains some lattice reduction techniques and solvers for the closest vector problem and the shortest vector problem. It also has toy functions which demonstrate the use of lattice tools. or a few problems of interest. We've given several examples here which use this hexagonal lattice. And specifically, we've used this basis illustrated here with red arrows. And you can see it's written in Julia code there as using the variable bred. And the question is what happens when we pass this not so great basis matrix into our LLL function? And we can see that it returns a better basis, illustrated here with green arrows, which has the same orthogonality and length properties as we showed earlier. In other words, it's a better basis for this lattice than the red basis. Because we're using Julia, and because we've paid attention to it when writing the LLL function, we can handle user-defined subtypes. For example, here we're accepting, we're constructing a basis matrix which uses a bit integer type for the real and the imaginary parts. And our LLL function works just fine on it. There are lots of fun applications of Lattice tools. One of the earliest applications was to solve the cryptographer subset sum. The code in the center of the page shows the solution, or shows code for solving a big int problem where we have 190-bit integers. So I have a challenge for you, which is to find or write a tool to beat the speed of this tool, either in the big int scenario above or in scenarios which use 64-bit math. It's a pleasure for me to be a tiny part of the Julia community. I've always enjoyed JuliaCon. Thank you for watching my JuliaCon video.